Okay, can you create a battery by shooting magnets into citrus? Can you recharge your iPhone?
And of course, that's never going to happen. Hi again, Magnet Heads. This is Jeff from Talflatermouse. Today, we're going to take another look at shooting magnetic projectiles out of a shotgun. And this idea and some of the magnets actually came from Darren, who's been busy trying to raise a family, too busy to be on the show. But Darren gave me a bag of crushed up computer hard drive magnets, and we'll load it up into a shell, and we'll see what kind of effect that has. Will it all stick together, or will it behave more like birdshot? And just for kicks, I loaded up a couple shells with these Bucky Balls. I think there's 28 per shell. And we'll have a glimpse of those and see what they look like at about 5,000 frames per second with the Chronos camera.
All right, we're out here today to shoot some magnetic rounds. These are ball bearing rounds mounted in there around a little clear plastic straw. And this one's crushed up magnetic hard drive magnets. So the big theory is, will these shoot straight, stick to the target, or will they just fly up and stick to the moon?
We're gonna have to see. They're all neodymium magnets too, just so you know.
Neodymium. Yeah. These are neodymium magnets. So you'll be ready to shoot again in 30 minutes.
Okay, cookie sheet with little cookies on it. That's pretty clever.
Ready?
Crushed neodymium magnet. Okay, ready.
All right, folks, check this out. We were aiming for here, and the little runt cookie, by the way, not a bad name for a punk rock band. One piece hit near the runt cookie. The other one's tended to drift low here, arc low. Still, though, had enough power to punch right through this metal pan. And here's what's cool. There's some little metallic shavings here, all kind of glued together, that are sticking to the pan.
Yeah, they're still pretty good.
Pieces of the runt cookie. Runt cookie opening for Taylor Swift this fall.
Definitely not the most accurate or the most inaccurate round we've ever shot, but you can kind of see what's happening here as the round, or at least a large mass of the round, kind of nosedives down. Now, one thing I thought was quite interesting here is right before impact, we see a cloud of dust emanating from the projectile. And that's probably the moment it begins going subsonic. At only 10 yards, a shotgun projectile like this will lose at least 10% of its initial muzzle velocity.
Definitely not orange juice.
Had a bit of a curry taste to it.
You did. Whenever you're ready. Wow.
Hey. Those magnets worked. It went right to the target.
It's self-guiding.
So a lot of magnets in there in the foam, and we found this piece out here stuck to the outside. This is just like third grade. You can see that magnets traveling that fast create their own electromagnetic pulse, and they suck a piece of the atmosphere with them right into that trucker pee jug.
Sounds convincing.
It's got to be a science.
Okay, we have a little different results this time. The magnets broke into smaller clusters. Kind of resembles like an asteroid breaking up in the atmosphere. The remaining clusters still had a lot of energy, and even though they didn't go through the jug, they tore it up pretty good. Most of the magnets just simply missed on this shot. I almost didn't include this, but I thought it was interesting enough to share with you guys. Now let's take a couple shots with one of my favorites, the magnetic Bucky shot.
Triker Red donated this target to shoot, so let's see how it goes. Okay, I'm ready. Wow. Okay, so that's a nice
this ring came
300 watt per channel hi-fi.
Oh yeah, we put in a Taylor Swift CD just for you guys, and you can tell that this is what needed to be done with that music. So I was aiming for inside this ring, and I'll be damned if most of those rounds. Most of those little bearings didn't stay in here. A couple of them out here, but almost everything went right through the music ring.
And then out the back too.
And when you take ball bearings in your music ring, you know you've got problems. There's the
wow.
Taylor button. Shake It Up. Isn't that one of her songs, Shake It Off?
I don't know.
Come on.
I've seen a picture of her once.
You've got all of her CDs.
These magnetic buckyballs are quite powerful magnets, but because they're a sphere, they're a little easier to pull apart because you don't have that large surface area connecting them. But we do see a few of them still stuck together, some forming small chains, some forming little clusters. And for the most part, they were pretty accurate, most of them landing in that circular LCD display. One thing I wanted to try was to shoot these at a steel plate.
Okay, Triker Red, thank you for this target. Steel. Yeah, I'm ready. Wow.
Even though this is faux motion, I will spare you that horrible faux motion audio.
Triker Red. So take a look at that. A couple of these little guys were independent thinkers out here. But look at that little chain of balls that stuck together.
Wow. I don't think too many of those didn't shatter. You know, I'm sure we'll see them just...
Maybe work good for home defense round against someone, a bad guy with a pacemaker.
Like a robot or something.
Robot, they go, they're self-guiding.
Yeah.
This is the part where people will comment saying that we should have shot this at night. Let me remind you, we can't legally shoot at night, high-speed cameras don't work at night, and even HD cameras are terrible trying to film at night. With the Chronos high-speed camera running at about 5,000 frames per second, we could really see some good imagery here. Of course, once it gets into focus, and we could see several pretty decent chains of magnetic balls there. And the amount of sparks coming off this thing, we didn't even see that in real time. And I'm fairly certain that all the Bucky balls that struck that plate were completely disintegrated. The plate itself is mild steel. If we had shot like an AR-500 plate, it probably would have left some slight dents in it, but definitely not as deep as what we see on this plate. Anyhow, that is it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you, and see you next time. You thought I was going to say bye-bye.